Hey, nobody ordered you to eat yet.
Yeah, but...
Hey, I know what to do. Langtree, play something like this.
Oh, like this?
Good enough. Oh, potatoes and molasses. If you want some, oh, just ask us. They're warm and soft like puppies in socks, filled with cream and candy rocks. Oh, potatoes and molasses. They're so much sweeter than algebra class. If your stomach is grumbling and your mouth starts mumbling, there's only one thing to keep your brain from crumbling. Oh, potatoes and molasses. If you can't see them, put on your glasses. They're shiny and large, like a fisherman's barge. You know you eat enough when you start seeing stars.
Animal crackers in my soup. Monkeys and rabbits loop-a-loop. Gosh, oh gee, but I have fun swallowing animals one by one. In every bowl of soup I see lions and tigers watching me. I make them jump right through wahoo, those animal crackers in my soup. When I get hold of the big bad wolf, I just push him under the ground. Then I bite him in a million bits and I go pull him right down. When they're inside me where it's dark, I walk around like Noah's Ark. I stuff my tummy like a goop with animal crackers in my soup. Animal crackers in my soup do funny things to me. They make me think my neighborhood is a big menagerie. For instance, there's our janitor. His name is Mr. Klein. And when he hollers at us kids, he reminds me of a lion. The grocer is so big and fat, he has a big mustache. He looks just like a walrus just before he takes a splash. Animal crackers in my soup, and rabbits loop the loop. Gosh, oh gee, but I have fun swallowing animals one by one. In every bowl of soup I see lions and tigers watching me. I make them jump right through a hoop, those animal crackers in my soup. When I get cold of the big bad wolf, I just push him under the ground. Then I bite him in a million bits and I go pull him right down. When they're inside me where it's dark, I walk around like Noah's Ark. I stuff my tummy like a goop with animal crackers in my soup.
Oh, potatoes and molasses. It's the only thing left on your tusk. Plus they're short and stout to make everyone shout for potatoes and molasses. For potatoes and...
didn't invest in his school for fun. I thought we were trying to do important work here, teaching animals to count and spell.
We are. Oh, please, Father, don't close the school. It won't happen again.
I should say it won't. This, meow, and this are all coming with me. Now send them to bed.
You heard, Father. Off to bed with you.
Oh, my goodness.
Singing in the dining room. Madam, is this the kind of manners you teach them?
Why, of course not, Mr. Wyckoff. They've been told they must always be quiet at mealtime.
Oh, they've been told, have they? Well, just telling them doesn't seem to be good enough. Perhaps a bit of real discipline wouldn't do them any harm. Have you been told not to sing in the dining room?
Yes, sir.
Then why do you do it? You're a bad and wicked child. You know that, don't you?
She isn't a bad or wicked child. She's just a baby. She was making the children laugh.
Besides, it wasn't her fault. I told her to sing for the children.
And who are you, young woman? Are you an orphan, too?
Yes, sir.
Then what right have you to be here, living on charity at your age?
I'll tell you what I'm doing here. I scrub the floors and make the beds and wash and iron and cook from 6 in the morning until 9 at night.
Quiet!
I won't be quiet. You're a mean and hateful man to frighten little children.
Betty? Report to my office after the meeting.
Yes, ma'am.
The rest of you will go to the main yard and wait there till it's time for inspection by our dear trustees.
Yes, ma'am.